Ladies and gentlemen, now on yesterday's Cavalier Crystal opening, we said if we could smash out 4,000 likes that today we would return to spend $200 on this mobile video game. But if the enablers can assemble and rally hard and smash out 5,000 likes on today's video, give that like button a proper Mia Khalifa pounding, then tomorrow we will return for one final round of spending $200 to try and awaken our 6-star guillotine. So enablers, it is up to you. Destiny is in your hands there, but we've had a bit of a 6-star drought the last almost like a couple of months now, man. We've opened about 280 featured Cavaliers, and we've got one 6-star champion. And that 6-star was Sabertooth, so a great pull, but still 280. Like, when the drop rate is meant to be, I think it's just like 1.5%. It's just so, so dry, man. So hopefully, today's crystal opening, we are going to bring it back to a level of glory, lads. It can't be 300 featured Cavaliers of only one 6-star. That'd be so bad, and one of the worst streaks I've ever been on. That's going back to like the normal Cavaliers when we did an initial opening there. But let's go for the tactic that we went for yesterday, because yesterday we went for Pep's new strategy of like buy the crystals and then go out two times, and then on the third one start opening the crystals. And yesterday, bro, we got almost a 50% 5-star ratio. We had like at one point it was 9 out of 21 crystals, but it was 9 out of 22 overall. We got so many 5-star champions, it was mad. But that definitely made up for the first opening, because on the very first opening we didn't get a single 5-star champion. So we just about, you know, balanced ourselves out when it comes to the guillotine crystals. But let's go in for that third time and start spinning these bad boys, man. Hopefully today we can get that 5-star Aegon, 6-star guillotine awakened, or like any useful 6-star champion would be very much appreciated. But let's have a look. We're going to be starting today. Crystal number one coming around that corner is going to be a 4-star version of Miss Marvel. I thought we were going to awaken the 6-star Loki then. Would have been a fairly nice way to start the crystal opening, but alas, you know, 4-star Miss Marvel, not really too much to say there, apart from slightly better than a 3-star champion. Well, let's go on to crystal number two, and it's going to be landing on a 4-star Ghost Rider. So a nice rollover from Human Torch, but again, not really what we're looking for today, lads. We want those 5-star, those 6-star champions. Any 6-star champion today, apart from Rocket Raccoon or Cable or like any champion that I already have awakened, man. I think there's only a few of them. So let's have a look. Crystal number three today is going to be landing on a 4-star version of Morningstar. So we've got a very consistent 4-star ratio so far, which is, it's all right, man. It's better than a very consistent 3-star ratio, but it's really all there is to say about that. But let's have a bit of a look. Crystal number four, and coming around that corner is going to be a 4-star version of Sentry, the man with the power of a million suns. And we actually do have a 6-star version of Sentry, but I'm not really doing any gameplay with that man until he is awakened. Just because, like, without his awakened ability, you can't transfer his what is it? It's like pre-fight ability from fight to fight. So it just makes him long to ramp up in all sorts of encounters, man. But let's have a look. Crystal number five is going to be landing on a 3-star version of Mephisto. This opening has been nothing short of slightly tragic so far. Seems like we're paying for the insane 5-star ratio that we had yesterday. But that was an overdue payment from the first opening. So I'm hoping that we get something a little bit spicy. But hey, all the best openings, man, they start with a bad start and a strong finish. And that's going to be a 4-star guillotine. So certainly not too bad. Doesn't awaken our 4-star version. And the doesn't even awaken that, man. Adds an additional 20 levels. And that being the featured champion, I think we get like double the 5-star chance as well. So a small silver lining there. But earlier today, if you missed it on the channel, we did do a 3-star Realm of Legends like end part of the run with Guillotine 2099, man. And even as a 3-star, she absolutely demolishes Realm of Legends. So it's definitely a good one to check out, man, if you're on an interesting Guillotine video. Or 5-star Namor there. Not too bad. We've already got him a Sig 200, man. But hey, that would have been great a few weeks ago to save me an Awakening gem. But regardless, it's still a 5-star champion. It's really good when the crystals stop in and there's just like great stuff in sight absolutely everywhere. So yeah, we'll take that, man. That's also a max signature ability crystal to open at the end of today's crystal opening. So maybe a chance at 6-star Immortal Iron Fist as well. But let's have a look. Crystal number 8 is going to be landing on a 3-star version of Agent Venom there. So not really exactly what we're after. But let's keep on pushing forward, man. I reckon there's going to be something good in the next 12 crystals. We've got to break the 6-star drought, lads. Come on, 6-star champions, where are you at? And that's going to be a 5-star version of Guillotine 2099. Amazing champion to add to the collection. We already have the 6-star, so she's probably not going to get ranked up too much. But hey, we might play around with the 5-star because we can get her up to... rank 3, and that's at a fairly mid-tier level, and maybe see how she performs at 5-star rank 3. If people want to see the gameplay, let me know in the comment section below. But let's go for crystal number 10, and we've awakened. Oh man, I thought we could awaken 5-star Guillotine there. But you know, overall, not bad in the end. Like, Guillotine and Namor, bro, if I didn't have those two characters, this would be like a, easy beyond god tier Cavalier stack of 10. But yeah, it is what it is when you got a Blubbery Whale roster. So let's jump into the next stack of 10. So that method of buying 10, going in and out, has like a 100% success ratio so far for every stack that we've tried in terms of getting like a fairly decent stack. So let's, you know, maybe it's just a bit of a conspiracy there. Maybe it's all false, but I, you know, I'm enjoying this level of luck. If we could go a bit more toward the 6-star end of stuff, that'd be greatly appreciated. But we've got a lot of good characters in the last 30 or so Cavalier crystals. But anyway, let's go for number 11, and it's gonna be a 4-star version of Thor Ragnarok there. I need to do a video kind of playing about my 5-star version of Thor at some point with the full synergies, because he's certainly not the best champion, but he can be a little bit enjoyable to play if you like fully commit to Team Thor. So we'll maybe do that at some point this month, or maybe in December, we'll see. But more levels on the 5-star Thor would be appreciated. Okay, we got a 6-star champion. It's 6-star Captain America World War II, who we already have, but that gives us his awakened ability. Which gives him a little bit more block proficiency. Overall, I'm glad we got a 6-star. That doesn't really do too much for us, though. But hey, it is a 6-star champion, so there we go, boys. There we go. But Captain America, you know, World War II, he's been out of the conversation for a while. But hey, that's pretty decent, man. I'll definitely take that off a single Cavalier there, and a 5-star Yellow Jacket to follow up as well. A pretty good champion pull there. You know, it's a 5-star, gives us some more 6-star shards. So not too bad, boys. This stack is good a little bit interestingly so far. But yeah, I remember doing a 6-star Captain America gameplay video last year, and I was a little bit disappointed in the 6-star power level. I don't think the awakened ability is going to bring him up that much, but who knows, boys? Who knows? Right, that's going to be a 3-star version of Rocket Raccoon there, kind of settling back down to the average odds on these crystals. But hey, I guess, you know, we broke the 6-star drought. Not maybe quite the way that we wanted to break the 6-star drought, but a 6-star champion is a 6-star champion, and we still have 5 more chances, boys. We still have 5 more chances to get somebody that is pretty damn spicy as a 6-star character. So let's have a little bit of a look. We've got crystal number 16 now. And who's going to be coming around that corner? We are going to be landing on a 3-star man thing. It's just nothing that good. I tried to raise my voice and hoping that there was something exciting coming around the corner. But alas, disappointed, lads. Disappointed. But let's go in for crystal number 17 now. And hopefully we can get somebody pretty good. It's been a relatively decent opening so far today. But let's have a bit of a look. And it's going to be a 3-star version of man thing again. So yeah, not quite what we wanted, but we got so many dupes on Man Thing, man. There's like one more dupe and then he's max sig, but hopefully we can avoid that and get many 6-star champions. That'd be the ideal scenario. Let's go, crystal number 18, and it's gonna be 5-star Moon Knight there. I would have liked to awaken 5-star Man Thing, but you know, brings Moon Knight up to 120 there. Moon Knight is a little bit rubbish, mate, a little bit rubbish, so Again, not exactly what we're after, but hey, it's a 5-star champion, some 6-star shards, and Moon Knight, you know, he's not too far off Max Sig now. But let's have a bit of a look, and it's going to be 6-star Mr. Sinister! Get in there, boys! This stack has been banging, mate! Yeah, that is great, man. Like, even on Awaken, that is a permanent champion that can annoy, like, a lot of people on Alliance War defense there. So that's a banger. Like, Mr. Sinister, if you really want to play around with him to be, like, a banger of a champion on offense, he kind of needs to be, like, awakened and at high sig. But even unawakened, bro, it's got some sick synergies. Really, really good for Alliance War defense. I'm proper chuffed for that one, lads. But let's go. Crystal, number 20, is going to be landing on a 3-star Moon Knight. But overall, bro, both stacks were sick today, like, especially the second one, because we've got 6-star Mr. Sinister, and also awakened our 6-star version of Captain America, World War II there, and got a 5-star Yellow Jacket, and also Moon Knight. So I think what we'll do is we'll go for our max signature ability, Crystal, and then we'll have one very cheeky stop at Celebration Station. So, where's the max sig? Let's quickly, should we spin this one out? Because there's a lot of different stuff you can get for it, man. 6-star Immortal Iron Fist, 5-star Awakening Gems. If we get a generic, that'd be really, really good. But we got the likely pull, which are the 6-star shards there. So, yeah, we've got enough now, I think, for another 6-star crystal to open at some point. I imagine next month, probably after the, what is it? The featured one has been updated. So that's going to be like just over 2 and a bit weeks, I think, now, because they did push it back. But let's go for one stop at Celebration Station. And come on, boys, if we could get one more 6-star champion today, that'd be so, so good. But I'm so happy that we managed to pull today's opening back with not one, but 2 6-star characters. But let's go. Final stop at Celebration Station. We are going to be landing on a 3-star version of Guillotine. Overall, man, a sick day. Really, really happy with the result. Definitely moving kind of in the right direction toward the Doom and Mr. Fantastic crystals. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, if you did enjoy today's crystal opening, please do smash that like button. That'd be greatly appreciated. And if we can smash out 5,000 likes by tomorrow, then we're going to go for another round of $200 worth of Cavaliers. So thank you very much for watching. Take care, and I hope that you have an absolutely fantastic day.